Greetings. I'd like to explain something, but I need to explain it using a harsh and grisly example. But my explanation is neither an endorsement nor a call to implement it. There is a certain calculus which might have ended World War II. It is an understanding of the situation during World War II. It is an oversimplification and does not attempt to include all possible variables. In World War II Germany, roughly 10% of the citizens of Germany were Nazis. The other 90% were not members of the Nazi Party, but I bet they were loyal Germans. Here is the oversimplified calculation presented for your consideration. If decent and peace-loving Germans were willing to go, one by one, and individually kill one Nazi, find one in a bar, a theater, on a road, in a store, and be willing to swiftly kill that Nazi, they would have killed every Nazi in Germany. No doubt the German citizen would have been killed, but the German population could have stopped World War II. Basically a pawn exchange across the board. 10% of Germans sacrificing themselves to kill the 10% who were Nazis. One for one. And 80% of all Germans would have lived. That is a very grisly calculation, I know. And as I stated, I am not advocating it as an approach of human behavior. Now, consider a religion that does advocate this behavior. Islam. Only Islam does not think one for one is necessary. The strategy of Islam uses terrorism to multiply the effect. Each act of Islamic terrorism to kill as many as possible. As a religion, Islam enjoys the fantasy of promise. The promised fantasy is that if a Muslim will kill infidels for Allah, blow themselves up for Allah, they get orgies for eternity, gluttony for eternity. And because Islam represents itself as a religion, it claims such authority over eternal power. Restated, Islam claims that its deity, Allah, makes such promises. That is a pretty dreadful situation if you consider it from a purely secular perspective. How can nations and armies and police stop a whole religion at war with the rest of the world? How can nations and armies stop a whole religion where each and every follower may at any time become a lone wolf? Think very long and you realize it cannot be done. The lone wolf Islamic attack against a Philadelphia police officer is just one such example. Islam is all for such cowardly and evil attacks. Unstoppable by the totally random nature. Totally random, but united by one predictor. Islam. Islam thinks it can conquer and dominate the world this way. A continued and persistent stream of violent and random killings. Islamic terrorism. Can you see the parallel to the calculus of Germany? Islam is flooding the free world right now with terrorists, refugees. Refugees not fleeing to any Islamic countries. Why? That is a very fair question to ask and ponder. The answer is, the refugees do not want safety in an Islamic country. The refugees want to spread Islam. And the secular liberal mind fires, they only want safety so they can live their lives. Challenge that thought with the obvious. Can a Muslim follow Islam in peace and safety better in an Islamic country or in a secular progressive evil country? A country where their children are taught homosexuality in schools. A country where Mohammed dolls are placed in jars of urine. A country where Mohammedans are called Quran thumpers. A country where Mohammedans' 5-times-a-day prayers are illegal in schools and the workplace. A country where Mohammedan children are taken by the state and indoctrinated against Islam. No rational group of people would migrate to countries aggressively persecuting their religion. Oh, wait. Liberal progressives only persecute Christians and Christianity. The goal of Christians must be different than the rest of the world, because only Christians are in the world, but not of this world. Our calculation must not be for self-preservation. We must focus on God's purposes, God's plans. Luke 6:38, bless those who curse you, pray for those who mistreat you. Matthew 5:44, but I tell you, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you. Love in the face of hate. Good in the face of evil. This truly is the fruit of Christianity. And the plan of God has been revealed in the Word of God for thousands of years. Pray for workers to enter the harvest of souls in these last days. Luke 10:2, and he told them, this is Jesus speaking, the harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few. Ask the Lord of the harvest, therefore, to send out workers into his harvest. Prepare your heart and mind for the trials and tribulation coming. If you think somehow Christians can militarily win this war, your thinking has most likely been shaped by replacement theology. But that is a topic for another video. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.